All right, we're going to start on this breaking news issue. Australian Charities and Not-for-Profits Commission. This is a body set up just basically to keep the honesty and the rigour inside the charities, have a whole series of rules because they get, as we know, charitable tax concessions and other things. It has revoked the charitable status tonight of Aussie Farms. Now, this is the activist organisation that put the maps out there, Nick Reece, on websites right around the country and invited the activists to storm farms, etc. What's also interesting, it was led by a guy called Chris Delforce, and his mother, Julie Delforce, Dr. Julie Delforce, was a senior bureaucrat at the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade inside the agriculture portfolio. Well, she has been stood down pending a serious internal investigation over claims that perhaps the information about the farms, their locations and the other detail on the maps, perhaps, came from her. Pretty serious stuff.
Yeah, it certainly is, and that's very serious if that turns out to be true, and the fact that her name is in the media means that her reputation as a public servant is already being done severe damage. So, yes, look, I hope for the department's sake that the evidence stacks up, and if it does, it's certainly a pretty serious breach. Look, we should make the observation that the Australian Charities Commission does not revoke the charity status of charities lightly. It does not happen very often. So I guess this just shows the seriousness of the allegations or the seriousness of the findings against Aussie Farms for them to have taken this very serious step. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, I think all of us would be supportive of the idea of helping the welfare of animals, but the way in which Aussie Farms went about it was just not on. I mean, encouraging people to trespass is not the act of a charity. And in order to preserve the standing and the status of all those other charities out there who do good work, you know, St Vincent's and many others, I think it's a good thing that they've stepped in. And I hope that Aussie Farms pulls down that map that it circulates as part of its efforts to try and encourage trespass upon Australian farms.
Well, of course, Daniel, in New South Wales last week, they passed through the Parliament a bill, which is now an act, it's law, about the right to farm, and it created the offence of aggravated trespass. So trespass is one or two individuals. Aggravated trespass is a group storming a farm, and it's going to really crack down hard on them. 3 years in jail, $30,000 sort of fines. But this is just the sort of the tip of the iceberg. If you go on the websites and you look at some of the names of so-called charities, a lot of them are activist fronts.
Yeah, that's right. I think this is a huge problem. It is the tip of the iceberg, and farmers have so much to deal with, whether it's the conditions, the drought and other environmental factors, whether it's the reams of red tape and regulation and environmental law they have to deal with. But there's also another piece of the puzzle, which is all of the government funding that goes directly to environmental activists like the Environmental Defenders Office that use that money, they use taxpayers' money to launch litigation against job-creating projects, whether it's in farms, whether it's like Adani, the Adani coal project. So government should be looking at removing funding that they provide directly to environmental activists that are making the lives of the resources sector, mining sector, farmers more difficult than what it needs to be, because ultimately they need to be able to have as much time, as much opportunity to get on with their jobs as possible and not to fear environmental activism.
Well, it's inside the ABC. I was just talking to Chris Kenny about it, Daniel. There's a whole sort of climate group being started up inside the ABC. It's supposed to adhere to a charter. It's supposed to be independent, but we're paying for activism.
That's right. It's activism. It's not journalism. We know that staff at the ABC are five times as likely as the general population to vote for the Greens. And so this is not a fair and balanced news organisation. It's an organisation that fundamentally is running a political agenda. It's been that way for a number of years. They're not sticking to their charter, and the government needs to take harsher action. Either they need to directly appoint more conservative commentators to the ABC, or they need to look at privatising the ABC. If it's not going to be an organisation for the whole of Australians, then there's no reason why all Australian taxpayers should be funding it. And in the long term, the government should be looking to privatise the ABC and to put that $1.1 billion every year into a much better use.
Well, I've got to pick you up on that, Daniel. I mean, look, that was a very good pitch there for your next job at the ABC, calling on them to employ more conservative commentators. But it has to be noted that many organisations around Australia have climate action groups as part of them. Certainly the University of Melbourne, where I work, does.
They don't have a charter to be independent, Nick.
And they're not taxpayer-funded. This is a taxpayer-funded organisation. If you're a private organisation, go for your life. You're getting $1.1 billion to be a news organisation. Report the news. Don't be activists.
Just because you're a publicly funded organisation doesn't mean you can't have an opinion about things. I mean, I've seen firefighters around Australia this week coming out calling for climate action. We've had leaders of the fire services declaring a climate emergency. I mean, I actually think it'd be a good thing if Sky News had a climate action advisory group. I might go and start one of those, I think. Peter, will you join?
Well, mate, you'd be lonely. I'm having a climate action push to actually get this climate hysteria off the agenda and actually have some common sense in relation to climate. I'll join a dams action group if you want to start one of those up, Nick.
Look, I'm not opposed to dams in the northern part of Australia. In other parts of Australia, most of the water is accounted for. But look, the science is very clear. More action needs to be taken on climate change. That includes at a workplace level. So I'm all for Sky News opening a climate action advisory group, and I'll send around the staff email later tonight, I think.
Yes, I think it'd be about as popular as socialism here. I want to ask you, what happened at the ALP, Nick, on the weekend? A walkout by some, and a no-show by Anthony Albanese. It's not all good, happy families down the Victorian ALP.
Oh, look, on the contrary, Peter, it's pretty much business as usual, I would say, for a Victorian Labor Party conference. You know, it's not a good conference if there isn't a Barney about something. You know, it's not a tea party, it's a political party. And so, look, there's very strongly held views, there's often passionate debates. And so, look, what we saw last Saturday was pretty much run-of-the-mill. Look, unfortunately, Anthony Albanese couldn't be there this conference, but, look, I'm pretty confident he'll be there next year.